You're listening to Health Professional Radio with Wayne Bucklar. Today, my guest is a visitor from America who's in Australia to attend the world-renowned Port Douglas Heart Meeting, where 300-plus cardiologists come together for a three-day conference. His name is Dr. Matthew Budoff. He's a published researcher with over 700 research papers and six books to his credit, and he's addressing the conference this week. Welcome to Health Professional Radio, Matthew.
Oh, well, thank you for having me on.
And welcome to Australia. I trust it's pleasant weather in Sydney at present.
Yep, very nice. I'm enjoying it. I was down in Melbourne. It was a bit colder, but not very nice in Sydney.
And if you're heading to Port Douglas, it's halfway across the country, and the weather will be much warmer, I can assure you.
I'm looking forward to it.
Now, Matthew, you're here to address the conference. What is it that you're going to be telling them?
So I'm going to be discussing, among other things, some of the cardiovascular benefits of aged garlic extract and some of my newest research in that field.
Now, that's aged garlic, the common, you know, like garlic we eat.
Yeah, so this is actually, yeah, I mean, it's garlic that we eat, but this is now aged for up to 20 months and purified, and then this is a capsule that we used in studies to see if it had a cardiovascular health benefit.
Okay, and what was the outcome of the research?
Yeah, so we took a group of patients and we put half of them on this aged garlic and half of them on placebo, no therapy, and the patients who got aged garlic actually had less plaque in their coronary arteries, reversal of heart disease, over the course of a year. So we were very pleasantly surprised and pleased that it had such a good effect on the heart health.
That's a remarkable outcome for something that we just see as a kitchen ingredient. And I guess from my position of ignorance that there's no side effects from eating garlic either.
Yeah, very few. You know, this formulation is aged over 20 months, so it doesn't have that harshness to it. So it's easier to tolerate as far as the stomach goes. If you eat a lot of raw garlic, a lot of people get stomach aches. And in addition, it's odorless, so you don't upset the people around you by being on garlic preparation.
Now, I have to be a little bit cynical here. People who listening to us are generally clinicians, and they're going to be skeptical and say, oh, come on, aged garlic. But this is research you've published, I understand.
Yeah, and, you know, I started out skeptical as well. I was a traditionally trained cardiologist, and I started doing the research with, you know, no promises to anybody on how it would come out, and our first little study came out positive, and it slowed down plaque, so we did a second trial that was larger to validate it, and that worked. And we've subsequently done trials now number 3 and number 4. This is the fourth study that we're coming out with. And they all basically point us in the same direction. So I think that it's real and it's reproducible. And I think it's an easy supplement to add to our regimen for some of our patients who are at risk of heart disease.
You're listening to Health Professional Radio with Wayne Bucklar, and I'm in conversation with Dr. Matthew Budoff, a renowned cardiologist who's here from the US to talk to the Port Douglas Heart Meeting next week. And he's been telling me about his research into aged garlic extract and the positive results it's had on reducing soft plaque and positive outcomes for patients. Matthew, with the numbers that you've had in treatment, have they been significant numbers of patients?
So, you know, we started out with pretty small numbers, and we now have over 200 patients randomized to either garlic or placebo, and we're actually embarking on a 100-person study, so that'll bring our totals up to well over 300. So while it's not the magnitude that we see with some of the trials with statins and blood pressure pills from Big Pharma, I think that it starts becoming a significant number of people to make observations on.
Yeah, it is. And you mentioned Big Pharma. I guess it's not easy to get a drug patent on garlic either.
Yeah. No, I mean, I think, you know, I'm sure they have some patents that protect this aging process, but because it's a food product, you know, they're not going to come out with a prescription product and have the, you know, the upside of these other therapies get.
And have you discussed this with other cardiologists previously? What's the reaction been amongst the profession?
Well, you know, I think that people are more accepting. You know, I mean, cardiac CT is how we took the pictures, the CT angiograms, and they've been around for a little while. They've been rebated here in Australia since 2011. So they, I think that, you know, they see the methodology. You know, I've done a number of studies in the field. So I think that we've been having pretty good uptake, to be honest, overall. And again, it's not because of one study. It's not because I'm just showing an aberrant, lucky trial. We've done four now. So it starts to, you know, when you can reproduce the work, it becomes more of a reality, I think, for most of us.
And I guess it's an easy enough trial to reproduce for cardiologists in practice if it has no side effects and there's no negative to it. I'm guessing that most patients are going to say, you want me to take a capsule full of aged garlic and it might improve my health? Why not? What's the downside?
Yeah, no, and they're not, you know, very expensive, and they're easy to tolerate, and it doesn't have that odor that, you know, some people give a telltale that they're taking a lot of garlic. This is odorless. So I think you're right. I think it's mostly upside, and you know, I mean, it's not going to hurt anybody to be on some garlic therapy.
Do you see a day when people who are generally, you know, in that at-risk category for cardiac issues, the aging and the obese particularly, are likely to take up aged garlic much like we take up fish oil as just an easy preventative that might do some good?
I hope so, and I'm hoping that I can do even larger studies with outcomes to kind of even firm that up better in the eyes of the skeptics out there. But I do think it's going to grow. You know, when I think about my ABCs of prevention and, you know, aspirin, blood pressure, cholesterol, diet, exercise, F is fish and fish oil, and G could be garlic. So it fits right in there in our little alphabet soup of preventive therapies.
That's always extraordinary to hear of research which is kind of out of left field. And what led you to the notion that garlic might be useful?
Yeah, you know, I was naive to this as well in my training, but this company, who makes this product, has published 700 published trials in peer-reviewed literature on the benefits or use of aged garlic extracts. So one of my colleagues turned me on to this as a preventive therapy that we could study, and I went to the company with no promises and said, look, I'd like to study this product, and they supported a small trial, and I said, well, you know, one study's not really good enough. That was only 20-something patients. We really need a bigger trial, and they funded a second one, and the data's just been positive, so now we're looking at diabetics next. We're going to look at this benefit potentially in diabetes. They obviously are at very high cardiovascular risk, might have more benefits from this potential reversal of atherosclerosis with aged garlic extract.
It's mind-boggling to me that something so obvious really should have taken so long before it became mainstream, and I guess I'll have a bunch of old nurses listening to me saying, we knew about this 40 years ago, but you wouldn't listen to us then.
That's right. You know, garlic goes back to 2,000 years ago. The ancient Greeks used it as a performance enhancer. So this is nothing new that we're coming up with. It's just a new look at an old product.
And now you have some evidence to back that up. It's been lovely chatting to you. As I said, I hope you have a lovely time in Australia, and I'm sure you'll enjoy Port Douglas. It's a magnificent part of the world. Thank you for chatting to us today.
And thank you for having me on. It's been a pleasure.
I've been talking with Matthew Budoff, a cardiologist who's here to address the Port Douglas Heart Meeting about the benefits of aged garlic extract. If you've just tuned in, then you can find a transcript of this story and a sound archive at www.hpr.fm. This is Wayne Buckler for Health Professional Radio.